Cheryl, as we've been walking around, we've noticed a few saplings where the shoots have died and kind of curled down like that. And this is a Western hemlock here, but we've also seen it on Douglas fir. Can you talk a little bit about what this is?
Right, yeah. And I actually have seen it on some of the planted Douglas fir too. Not every single one. It's some sort of a shoot tip dieback or wilt. And it just affects the growing shoots, the new emerging shoots. I'm just scattered here and there. It's not too widespread, and it's pretty unlikely to kill any of these trees. So it's just a light disturbance, but it does set them back a little bit, stresses them a little bit. So it's just one of the things that can slow down the regeneration.
And it's caused by a fungus?
It's caused by a fungus, yeah, okay. That's right.
So it's not something that's going to kill the trees, but it is going to set them back just a little bit and consume some of that new growth. So right. Slowing their overall growth and progress.
Right. And we had a fairly rainy late spring and early summer. And so it doesn't happen every year. It just seems to be when the weather conditions are right. Every now and then you get a bit of a flare up of it, you know, a bit of an outbreak, and then it goes away again. So you don't see it every year.
Does it impact your management at all, or is it just something that occurs in the forest and is just part of what's going on?
No, it doesn't impact anything. It's just something that we notice in the background, you know, and we keep an eye on it. But we've never had any problems with it. We've always been able to achieve our regeneration objectives despite it. So we just keep an eye on it, but it's not a big problem.
Okay, thank you.